Hi, my name is Frank Valentic and welcome to our Advantage February market update. Well, the holidays are over and it looks like the market started with a bit of a bang again as numbers that opened for inspections are quite high and the market auctions have started quite well. The first weekend there was only about 200 auctions, this weekend there was around 700, and this following Saturday we're going to have the first Super Saturday with over 1300 auctions, so that'll be a real bit of a litmus test for the market. But it looks like it's literally taken off where it left off last year, with clearance rates in the 70s and pretty strong buyer demand and buyer numbers coming through. The REIV released their December quarter results and showed some massive increases as the last 3 months alone saw median house price increase by about 7.3% and units increase by around 4%. And Melbourne's median price is now at an all-time high, so the median house price of $645,000 and the median unit price of $498,000 are the highest they've ever been, and surpassed the total numbers in April 2010 at the last peak, where the median prices were around $595,000 for houses and around $490,000 for units. So the market has definitely had some strong results. 22% growth overall for houses in the last 12 months and around 12% growth for units. So it is getting tougher for people to get into the marketplace with the competition. Melbourne's growth was just behind that of Hong Kong, which was the highest capital city growth across the world at about 24.9%. So just showing how strong the marketplace has become. Toorak led the way with the median price of 2.9 million to get into that suburb, and it was just ahead of Canterbury with a median price of 1.8 and Kew with 1.7 million. Going out 62 kilometres, you could get the most affordable real estate in Melton West with a median price of around 272,000. Units also showed some pretty strong growth, with the median price being the highest in Brighton and Brighton East with around 860,000, 840,000 medians. And then you didn't have to go out that far to get the most affordable median units. You had to go out to Sunshine West, which is around 12 kilometres west of Melbourne, and that had a median price of around 229,000. The REIV also released their January vacancy rate figures, and they were very consistent with the December figures. So they've been hovering around the 3% mark for the last 6 months, and really peaked at an all-time high of about 3.8% in winter when it is colder and a little bit tougher to lease properties. But it's been pretty consistent around the 3% mark, which is good news for landlords. Generally a balanced market is considered to see vacancy rates of around 3 to 4%, which is where they've been now. The market is picking up though, and our property management team have said the numbers that open for inspections are definitely a lot higher. We're getting multiple applications on properties, which hasn't happened for a couple of years. And we're also getting a number of properties there that we're getting applications above the asking price, which hasn't happened for a while. One such example was a house we purchased for an investor in Ascot Vale. We had 40 people trying to queue up and get in at the open for inspection. We had over 8 applications come in, and there was at least 3 or 4 of them at $800 a week, which was well above the $750 asking price, a $2,500 bonus, I suppose, to the landlord in that respect. We also had one in Albert Park, an Art Deco apartment in Phillipson Street, which had a $15 a week increased offer on the asking rentals. So hopefully signs that the rental market is finally picking up, because rents have been pretty flat and pretty stagnant in the last couple of years. Looking forward now, we look at what the economy is doing, and the new home sales are quite strong in the 2013 year. They're up by about 14%. So the other economic indicators are pretty solid. Inflation was well below the 3% band that the RBA likes to keep it at. Unemployment was rising, and that's something that was up about 6%. And one of the reasons why the RBA might keep rates lower to try and stem that. And so that was some of the economic data coming out. But interest rates stayed on hold, and You know, now they've been on hold for 6 months. I don't think there's been an increase for a couple of years. And the positive signs are that the interest rate market is probably going to be moving downwards rather than upwards because the NAB reduced their five-year fixed rate to around 5.4%, which is the lowest it's been for 20 years. And Citibank also reduced their variable rate by about 40 basis points. The big handbrake to this property market is usually interest rates. As interest rates go up, property prices have historically gone downwards. And as interest rates have gone downwards, property prices have tended to go upwards, which we've seen in the last 12 months with Melbourne's growth. The REIA are very much lobbying the government at the moment in terms of helping first home buyers, as first home buyers have dropped to a record low level of 12%. And they're trying to reintroduce the first homeowner grant for established properties, which most states abolished last July, including Melbourne, where the $7,000 grant for established properties was abolished, and there's a $10,000 grant for just brand new properties. And only 20% of first home buyers buy brand new properties, so it's not really helping most first home buyers get into the market. And now we're down at 12% levels, well below the 20-year average of 21%. They're also recommending that the first home buyers can use their superannuation as a deposit to help them get into the marketplace, which they can then pay back later. And that's successfully been used in Canada and other countries. And I really support some of these measures, as I think first home buyers really need a hand at the moment. Going back about 20 years, I bought my first home, a three-bedroom house in East Brunswick for $168,000. And you know, for first home buyers to buy that today would be about a $1.2 million property. So it's very hard and impossible to get into that market. Even for a one-bedroom apartment, you'd pay around $300,000 in that area. So they do really need some assistance in terms of getting into the marketplace. Our group locks purchases have been getting some great results for our clients, and we've seen some fantastic results, including recently we purchased some two-bedroom Art Deco apartments in Neptune Street in St Kilda for $412,000 late last year. And after a $30,000 renovation, the number of those were sold for $600,000, and one was leased for $450 a week, which is a marked improvement from the $250 a week rental it was getting prior to renovation. We also saw some fantastic results in Como Parade East Mentone, where we had a number of clients buy one bedroom villa units for around $220,000. One sold for $376,000 after renovation, and another client who bought two spent $15,000 on their renovation, had theirs revalued by the bank at $375,000, creating $250,000 equity, which is fantastic in only 6 months. They're also leasing their properties out now for $360 a week, and they were getting $140 a week to the previous tenant. So it's an amazing 8% return, and you don't need to go out to country or regional areas to get that. We can get that with our group buying strategy. Another great example was Charman Road in Cheltenham, where two clients bought some one-bedroom apartments, converted courtyards for $240,000. One recently sold for $396,000 after a $40,000 renovation. The clients there are leasing them out for $360 a week. So very good cash flow and very good positive cash flow type properties for our investors there. My hotspot prediction for this month is Reservoir, which is about 13 kilometres north of Melbourne. It's undergoing gentrification, young professionals and young families are moving into the area, and it's well below Melbourne's median prices, with the unit median being around $370,000 and the house median being $550,000. So just bought a few blocks of units and townhouses in Reservoir, which are part of our group blocks purchases. So you can visit our website for those current opportunities and our future opportunities. On the social front, we participated in the Think Pink Cancer Fun Run, and the team donated money to cancer for that. So if anyone is wanting to contribute as well, they can contact our office, as a number of our staff, including myself, have lost parents at a young age to cancer. We also had a great night out at the Superbox at the tennis, taking some of our premium club clients there. And the one thing I'll leave you with here, the last word is just do it like the Nike ad. All these investors have a mindset that they just do it, that they're positive and they just want to get on with it, get results and not worry about the market, not worry about interest rates and what's happening in the economy. So until next time, I'd love to chat to you in March, and thank you for listening to our February market update.